Now the topic is salivary gland imaging. So the parotid, submandibular and sublingual gland, they are regarded as the major salivary glands. So first I'm going to give a brief about this glands. So first is this parotid gland. So it is the largest salivary gland. It lies below the zygomatic arch, in front and below the ear. So it has this Tencin's duct, which is 5 cm long, and it runs over the masseter muscle and it opens into the oral vestibule opposite the, like near the second maxillary molar. Now this submandibular gland, it extends posteriorly from below first molar to the angle of mandible. It forms the part of the soft tissue on the medial margin of the mandible and the hyoid bone. So it has this duct which is known as Wharton's duct. It is 5 cm long and it runs forward medially and upward, and it opens into the mouth on the side of the lingual frenum. Then the sublingual gland. So it is located in the floor of the mouth on the surface of the mylohyoid muscles. There are numerous small ducts which are known as ducts of Ravenous, and they open into the floor of mouth. Now these small ducts, they may join to form a single duct, and this duct, it is known as duct of Bartholin, and it empties into the submandibular gland. So this is just a brief about all these three major salivary glands. Now starting off with the types of the salivary gland imaging. So if there is a disease of salivary gland, so all are these imaging procedures which can be done. So first is the conventional imaging. In that we can do occlusal OPG, that is your panoramic, or PA view. Then we can do sialography, CT scan, MRI, ultrasonography, and we can do a salivary gland scanning, which is known as scintigraphy. So in this, there are various elements such as iodine, bromine, etc., and these are used in this scanning procedure. Now starting off with the sialography. So it is a radiographic procedure for the detection and monitoring of the gland, that is your salivary gland disease. So we are monitoring the disease, salivary gland disease, and this is a radiographic procedure to detect that disease. Now it is used to examine the ductal acinar system and the major salivary gland by injecting. So basically in this sialography, you are injecting a radio opaque contrast medium into the gland to make them visible on the radiograph. The indications of the sialography. So indications is when there is inflammation or infections. So with advances in imaging techniques that enable to depict the soft tissue structures, so we can like see if there are any inflammatory or infection which is present in the salivary gland. Then second can be the calculi, that is the stones, which is known as sialolithiasis. So to determine the presence or the position of the stones, we are using this sialography. The next can be if there is ductal and glandular destruction, and it is due to the obstruction, because of the obstruction or strictures. So it can cause ductal and glandular destruction. So it becomes the indication for sialography. The next one is pain and swelling. If salivary gland, they have pain and swelling. Then the next is the tumors. If there are changes which are secondary to trauma, then again this becomes the indication for sialography. Now what are the contraindications? Contraindication is if the person is allergic to the compounds which contains iodine. So this becomes a contraindication. Then if the person, he have acute inflammatory or infection. If an acute infection is present, in that case you cannot do sialography. And if in a patient who is undergoing thyroid function test, again in that patient you cannot do sialography. The next is what are the advantages. Now advantages is there is high resolution of the duct system and there is controlled localized radiation dosed. And disadvantages are it is painful on injection. There is difficulty, so it is basically difficult to perform, and it can cause necrosis or irritation, and there can be allergy to some patients. So these are the disadvantages of sialography. Now how exactly you are doing this sialography? So the technique for sialography is, so it is the most sophisticated procedure which is performed with a fluoroscopically guided positioning and injection of a water soluble contrast medium. So what you are doing is you are just injecting a water soluble contrast medium into the gland by the means of catheter permutation technique. So with the help of this catheter, you are injecting a contrast medium into the glands. So a catheter and a guide wire are used in this procedure. So first, Tencin's duct, as you know, it opens near the second molar, and the duct, it runs posterior to the parotid gland along the surface of the masseter muscle. Then the orifice of the Wharton duct, it is located at the anterior portion of the floor of the mouth, and it basically runs on the surface of the mylohyoid muscle. So basically this is nothing but the Stenson's and the Wharton's duct. Then what you are doing is the duct orifice, they are sprayed with the topical anesthesia. So now you know where the duct orifice is, and then you are spraying the orifice with the topical anesthesia. Then what you are doing is, first the guide wire, it is inserted into the salivary duct through the orifice. Thereafter the catheter is inserted into along the wire and the wire is removed. So first, as we know, now we are using this catheter and guide wire. So guide wire is basically nothing but it guides through the orifice into the duct. So first you are using this guide wire and it is inserted into the salivary duct through the orifice. So with that orifice, which is like, now you know where the orifice of Wharton's duct is and where the orifice of Stenson's duct is. So with the help of this guide wire, you are inserting it into the orifice. Then what you are doing is, now you have inserted the guide wire, then you are inserting the catheter into it along with the wire, and once the catheter it is inserted, you are removing that guide wire. Then after the catheter it is filled with saliva, it is connected to the injection syringe and it has this connection tube which is filled with this contrast medium. So now this catheter, now you know, so you have inserted this catheter into the duct. So this catheter, it is filled with saliva, and after that it is connected to the injection syringe and it has this connection tube which is filled with the contrast medium. Now under the fluoroscopic imaging, appropriate position it is determined and then the contrast medium is injected. So basically you are just injecting this contrast medium after that. Then usually in the case of submandibular gland, the agent that is used is 0.5 to 0.75 ml, and for parotid gland it is 0.7 to 1 ml. Then after the injection of this contrast agent, the radiographs are taken. So basically the radiographs which can be taken for parotid, you can take a anterior posterior view or a panoramic view. Then submandibular, for a submandibular gland, you can take a lateral oblique view, and if a sialolith it is located into the anterior portion of the duct, then you can take a occlusal view radiograph. So after this, the catheter is removed. So after taking this radiograph, the catheter it is removed, and then the patient, he is instructed to suck a lemon or 1% solution of citric acid, and it is given to the patient, and then they are asked to rinse. So basically it's nothing but, because of this there is more production of saliva, and if there is dye, which is, so the contrast medium, if it is present into the duct, it gets removed with this. Then after this, take a post procedure that is known as delayed radiograph after basically 5 minutes. So you can take all these radiographs, any one of this radiograph, to confirm the evacuation of the contrast, as salivary gland, the normal salivary gland, it excretes 100% of the dye within 5 minutes after the removal of catheter. So basically you are just taking another radiograph to confirm whether all the contrast medium has removed, it is like completely evacuated from the salivary gland. And this is the complete procedure, that is the technique for your sialography. Now these are the appearances that you will see. So the normal sialography, now in parotid gland, you will see a tree in winter or a leafless tree appearance. So this is the normal sialography appearance for a parotid gland. Then for submandibular gland, you will see a bush in winter appearance. If there is sialodactylitis, that is the inflammation of the duct, you can see a sausage-like appearance. So these all are like the different appearances which you will see, and this can be asked as MCQs, so you should know, and even your VIVAs, like what is, like how is the normal sialographic appearance for parotid gland, then you should know it looks like a tree in winter or leafless tree. Then Sjögren syndrome, it has this cherry blossom appearance or a snowstorm appearance, and if there is an intrinsic benign tumor, it looks like a ball in a hand appearance. So these all are the different appearances that you will see in a normal sialography. And this is like in brief about sialography, and this is like very important salivary gland imaging technique. And that was it for this video. Thank you so much.